guys, it's Ramon from Eclectic Emissary, and today we're back with another food tour, man. And in Spain, it's going to be awesome. Of course, the country's known for the famous paella, tapas, and sangria. So we're going to have all of it from different regions and see which one's the best, man. Where do you have the best food in Spain? So stay tuned because it's going to be awesome. As Spain's capital, Madrid has a ton of traditional food options, plus very authentic restaurants that have been here for sometimes over a century. So highly recommend checking out Madrid's signature foods like churros dipped in chocolate. Also, the bocadillo sandwich is really good. And the amazing food market that you'll find at San Miguel. For an even more immersive experience, try signing up for a wine and tapas tour where a local will guide you around to the most authentic restaurants and give you tips about the city. It's definitely a great way to explore the city and taste new flavors. So I highly recommend it. Anyway, check in the link in the description to find some local food tours that we did in Madrid and Valencia. Now eating a bocadilla de calamare, a specialty in Madrid, so we gotta have it. This is a squid sandwich, so don't worry, it's fried squid, you know, super good. Anyway, there's this place called Bar La Ideal, which is amazing. It's only like €4, freaking insane. So we're gonna test this out. Pretty good. Calamaris are not bad. The bread is bad. I'm not gonna say that is. It's hard, but probably just gonna eat the calamari out of this. All right, so we got some pimientos, which are like these green peppers. Apparently, only one in every 10 is hot, and then the rest are just medium heat. So, taking a gamble, just eating them. So yeah, let's try it. All right, here we are in Madrid. Last night, eating tapas, once again, of course. And we got the famous La Patatas Bravas, the Iberico Jamon, which is my personal favorite, and croquetas, which are amazing. So we're taking in these sick rooftop views. Let's eat. Okay, the arroz negro is super good, man. The squid is super fresh and delicious. The rice is amazing, super flavorful. And the only thing to keep in mind, it does make your teeth a little bit black, but it's okay, because they're super good. All right, so it's dinner time, and of course, we had to head to a famous restaurant called La Pepica, which is one of the first places that made a paella, man. Of course, paella, this is the birthplace of it, Valencia. So we're gonna try it here and it's gonna be awesome. So let's go. All right, so we're in Valencia. So you know we had to go with the specialty. We went with the Valencia paella, man. And if you didn't know, it's actually not made of seafood. It's made with chicken and rabbit. So that's pretty interesting. All right, so we're gonna take this first bite of paella valenciana. So let's try it, man. We're out trying to get a big scoop in here. Really good, man. It has like rabbit, chicken. There's some vegetables in here. Is that like a giant bean? Not sure what that is. But the rice is like thick. I don't know how to say, but it's very savory. Super good, man. You guys gotta try this. So once again, we ordered tapas because it is one of my favorite things. So I'll go into the history of a little bit that we learned from our guided tour the other day. Actually, tapas comes from the word to cover. So usually when people went to a bar, they would there'd be a lot of flies and stuff, so they would order like a bread or something to put over the drink. So tapa over to cover it, and I guess the word just ended up sticking. So now people, when they go out to drink, they're always ordering small plates, so tapas. But there's also one distinction between tapas and raciones, which is raciones are shared dishes, so dishes for the table, everyone picks out them together, and tapas are kind of just small plates, like individual tiny meals.
Salud.
Hey, so we're at this restaurant in Valencia called Casa Roberto. This was actually recommended to us by our tour guide, so he definitely knows what he's doing. This is a little bit of a fancier place, but they have traditional Valencian food, and it's amazing. Like, so far, we ordered the escaret con bacalao y pimientos, which is super good, and the croquetas de bacalao were fantastic. That's probably one of the best ones we've had. And of course, we ordered a paella, so we're gonna keep this paella train going, man. Let's see how this thing is. All right, since we got the seafood paella, actually, I think I just love seafood. This one's probably the best paella I've had so far. And of course, we're in Valencia, so you gotta have it. Try it here. It's one thing to keep in mind about the paella. Usually, the minimum serving is for actually two people. And so even if the listing price says, like, for instance, $20, it's gonna charge you twice for those two people. So it's gonna be a little bit more expensive, you know, depending how many people are ordering the paella. So just keep that in mind. All right, so first off, in Ibiza, is obviously gotta get some food. So we stopped at this restaurant over here, right on the beach. Not gonna lie, it was so expensive, so overpriced. It was like $50 for an appetizer, like $35 for a salad. It was like insane. The vibes were pretty cool and the food actually was really good. So I gotta say that, but if you're coming to Ibiza, get ready to spend those dollar bills, yo. Barcelona is the capital of Catalonia and a very international city, so you get to try a huge diverse of specialties in this region, and it's considered a paradise for any foodie. We're in Barcelona and we ordered the chicken paella, and it is delicious, man. It's pretty good, I'm not gonna lie. I think all paellas have been pretty consistent throughout the trip, so it's really just a matter of preference. I don't don't know if I talked about jamón ibérico, but it's like the cuts of beef, Iberian ham. It's so good, man. It's probably one of the best foods to have in Spain. A little bit salty and kind of pricey depending where you find it, but it's delicious, so you gotta have it. Nacional. This is like another food market, but super bourgeoisie, man. This is so fancy. And there's a lot less little things to eat, and there's more specific restaurants to eat at. But it looks pretty good, man. I'm actually kind of excited. At this other tapas place because I freaking love tapas. It was amazing. The food was so freaking good, really high quality stuff, and some of the best meals that we've had. And we ordered crema catalán, which is a specialty here in Barcelona, because if you didn't know, you know, we speak Catalan here. So let's try this.
All right, last meal in Spain, and we decided to go with paella, man, one last time. Seafood paella, because we're by the beach in Barcelona and I love seafood, so we're gonna do this, man. It's one of our favorite foods and I think it's one of the best in Spain.
All right, and there you have it, our entire experience of the Spain food tour. It is an incredible country with so much regional diversity and there's so much different kinds of foods to try. So whether you're having a giant pan of paella or a variety of tapas at your local bars, there is so much flavors to be hidden here, and it really is a great time and had a lot of fun. I personally favorite the jamón ibérico and seafood paella. I think that was also one of my favorites, but you guys let me know in the comments, what is your favorite region to try food, or what do you think the city has the best food? Anyway, as always, thanks for watching and stay tuned because we got more adventures coming up. Anyway, peace out.